Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. In continuing with our fermented dry cured sausage series, today I'm going to make something that is a fennel sausage. So in this bin, I have pork, and I have 80% lean and 20% fat. Let's get right into grinding it, and we'll talk about the spicing later. Okay, so the meat has been ground. There's a tiny little bit of meat in the hopper here that hasn't gone through the plate yet. Everyone tells me about the bread trick. I take some of the already ground meat and just put it through a second time. It's not going to be ground any finer going through that same plate, but it will push the unground stuff through, and it'll leave a little bit of ground meat in here that I can pull out as I clean out the machine. So we're fully ground at this point. I turn the machine off. I'm going to put the ground meat back in the fridge and keep it cold while I assemble all of the spices and the mixer. See you in a moment. So I've got all the spices together. Now we need to mix this up. And it's part of it is mixing the spices into the meat, but it's also mixing the meat together and making it really nice and sticky. Sort of an emulsification process that's helped along by the mixing and by the liquids that we're going to add. So I'm going to use a stand mixer with the paddle attachment, because that works really well, and I have a stand mixer. If you wanted to have a go with this with your hands, go right ahead. It takes a little bit of time. Just stick with it. It's really not that hard. Just use what you've got, and it'll be okay. So, on with the paddle mixer. And we'll turn this on, just on low. Don't send the meat everywhere. And we'll mix that up quite a bit before we add in the spices. Okay, so it's been a couple of minutes and the meat is starting to get sticky. So now we're gonna add everything in. I have some fennel seed and I've just ground that up a little bit in a mortar and pestle, not to a really fine powder. There's still chunks of the seed in there. Next in, black pepper. This is some crushed garlic. Get that in there. Next in is some salt. Now the salt is there for flavor, but it's also part of the curing process. The salt will help us deter bad bacteria from growing. And that's where this next one comes in as well. This is prog powder number 2 or cure number 2. That will again help deter the growth of bad bacteria. Now a lot of people won't use it. A lot of people say that it's bad for you. I'm looking to err on the side of caution because I don't have a long history of making this type of sausage. And so if that stops bad bacteria from growing, I'm all in. Next is dextrose. And dextrose is a simple sugar, monosaccharide. It's not gonna make the sausage sweet, it's just going to help the really good bacteria get a foothold. That's what they eat, so they can get on the ground running. Next in is some milk powder. And then some red wine. And be careful with the red wine. Don't let it slosh and splash everywhere as you pour it in. And finally, the starter culture. Okay, this is looking really sticky, and it doesn't take long. 3-4 minutes. You don't want to beat it too long because you don't want it to warm up. At the same time, you want to beat it long enough that it gets sticky. And there are a lot of people who will show you how you put this on your hand and then hold it upside down. And if it doesn't fall off, it's ready. You'll also just sort of get to a point where you realize it's ready. You're going to look at it and go, yeah, that's good. So I'm going to put this back into this tray and I'm going to stick it into the fridge while I get ready for the stuffing. Okay, the smaller dry ager is set up down here in our brewery. It's just getting so crowded out in the cooking studio. I moved it to the brewery. I'm going to hang these sausages in here with the others. Now the idea is they're going to hang in here for 3, maybe 4 weeks. The amount of time that they hang isn't the important factor. The important factor is you need them to lose around 30% of their weight before they're ready. And that sort of determines their doneness. That 30% loss in water weight is what makes them safe without needing to cook them. Now, times, temperatures, and humidities will all be in the description box below the video with the recipe. We'll check in on these in a couple of weeks and look at the mold growth And I will see you for a tasting when they're done. These are looking really good. Let's get them out to the studio and give them a taste. Pretty good.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hi, friends. How did this week's turn out?
I think this one's pretty good. It smells good. We lost the appropriate amount of weight. Actually, we lost more weight than we needed to because life gets in the way and I didn't get it out of the dry ager in time. But I don't think that's a problem, that it lost extra weight. So a couple of slices. Now, this one. Fennel right off the top.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's nice. That's very reminiscent of the fresh sausage that we made.
Mm-hmm.
That recipe we got from your Uncle Carmen. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's got a strong fennel flavor. So yeah. But that's really the dominant flavor.
That is the dominant flavor, yeah. I mean,
I didn't make it either. Are there other flavors in there?
Well, I mean, even the name of the sausage is fennel. So, as a traditional sausage, it's called fennel. I kind of like
it's
that.
It's very
one.
Good.
I like the texture on that too. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that one's a winner. Sorry, Glen. Glen's busy chewing. So, sorry, I forget what I'm supposed to say.
So this is a winner. I like this one. A little bit of refinement, of course, with everything. The first time you make it, it's not going to be perfect. It could use a little bit of refining, but really easy to make, and I think I'd do it again and just maybe tighten my technique a little bit and refine the spicing. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.